And now, all new at 5 o'clock, the controversy surrounding President Trump and allegations of sexual misconduct before he took office are growing tonight, with more members of Congress calling for an investigation into his actions. CBS4's Elliot Rodriguez is in the control room now with the administration's response. Elliot.
Well, Rutabaga, sexual harassment allegations against President Trump are not going away. Yesterday, we heard from some of his alleged victims. Today, we're hearing from Democratic lawmakers who are calling for his resignation. And a tweet by the president today against a New York senator is being called a sexist smear.
We got everybody here?
Democratic women in Congress are urging their colleagues to investigate allegations of sexual misconduct against President Trump.
I stand here demanding accountability, a full investigation from Congress when the White House will not provide its own.
The demand comes after three of the president's accusers spoke out on Monday. 13 other women have come forward with similar claims.
I believe that they would find enough proof to, you know, show that he had had this misconduct and he's not fit for office.
New York Senator Kirsten Gillibrand has already called for the president's resignation, prompting this fiery tweet in which Mr. Trump called Gillibrand a lightweight and someone who would come to my office begging for campaign contributions not so long ago and would do anything for them.
I see it as a sexist smear. I mean, that's what it is. And it's part of the president's effort at name calling, and it's not going to silence me.
After signing the Defense Authorization Act, the president was asked what he meant.
Mr. President, what did you mean when you said that Kirsten Gillibrand would do anything for a campaign contribution?
The question also came up at the daily press briefing.
Gillibrand owed an apology for the misunderstanding of the president's tweet this morning because many, including the senator, thinks that it's about sexual innuendos.
I think only if your mind is in the gutter would you have read it that way.
The White House has promised a list of eyewitnesses to exonerate the president. So far, two have been quoted in news articles questioning the accuser's stories.
Now, federal campaign finance records show that President Trump donated $4,800 to Senator Gillibrand's Senate campaign back in 2010. Rick Rutabaga, back to you.